we're going to do some practice on what we call quadratic substitution, on problems that are otherwise ridiculously obscene, and we're going to turn them into problems that are not so obscene so that we can actually solve them. So we've got these really hideous problems, x plus 2 quantity squared plus 6, x plus 2 plus 5, and all this other junk. So we're going to kind of tackle these one at a time. But first of all, what we're going to do is draw a comparison. So take a look at problem 1. We have x plus 2 squared plus 6, x plus 2 plus 5. Now hopefully if I said, what if I just wanted you to solve this? Would you be okay with it? Would that work? Hopefully the answer is yes. Hopefully you'd say, sure, I can go x plus 5 times x plus 1 is 0. So that means either x plus 5 is 0 or x plus 1 is 0. So that means if I subtract 5 on both sides, that x is negative 5 or x is negative 1. Right? So no sweat. All right. So essentially what we're going to do now is we're going to take this problem here and we're going to try to convert it into something that looks a lot more like this problem that you now see up on top. All right. So we've got this problem now. Hopefully you can see some parallels. We have something squared. Here's something squared plus 6 times something. So we have plus 6 times something plus 5, right? Not too bad. So these problems are actually super duper similar. So what we're actually going to do is we're going to do substitution. We're going to say substitution. We're actually going to say, all right, so these problems are essentially the same. We've got something squared plus 6 times something plus 5. It just so happens that my something is x plus 2. So instead of using x plus 2, I'm just going to let, we usually say u for some reason. I'm going to let u equal to x plus 2. So if I did that, then everywhere I see an x plus 2, I'm just going to write a u. So over here, I have x plus 2 quantity squared. So I'm just going to write, instead of x plus 2, I'm going to write u squared. And then plus 6, instead of putting x plus 2, I'm going to put u plus 5 equals 0. So I've got now u squared plus 6u plus 5 is 0. And check it out. I now have essentially this problem up here. I can write u plus 5 times u plus 1 equals 0. So that means u plus 5 is 0 or u plus 1 is 0. So that means if I subtract 5 from both sides, that u is equal to negative 5, or u is equal to negative 1. All right, so I'm basically done, but not quite, because I've got to substitute back in. All right, substitute back in. So instead of u, I'm going to put x plus 2. So I'm going to substitute backwards. Instead of u, I'm going to put x plus 2. Alrighty. So I've got x plus 2 is 5, negative 5. So I'll subtract 2 off of both sides and get x equals negative 7. Subtract 2 off of both sides and get x equals negative 3. So my solution here is actually x equals negative 3 or negative 7. So I've got two options. So see, we took a problem that we didn't know how to solve, and we turned it, oops, into something that theoretically we did know how to solve. So that's what makes substitution pretty special.